Good afternoon, everybody. It's me, Katrina, Crochet World. It's May 7th. I haven't been on for about a month now. It's due for a video. Just wanted to show some of the yarns I've done and some of the projects that I have finished. I went out and bought quite a bit of cotton. A bunch of people wanted me to make them some dish cloths and dish towels and stuff like that. So and I saw this nice yarn. It's by Burnett. It's handcrafted cotton scrub off. And I wanted to make some scrubbies with it. This color is the Light Breeze. It's a medium 4 weight. Crochet hook is 4.5 millimeter. The knitting needle is 4.5. And the crochet hook is 5 millimeter. 100% cotton. 8.8 ounces, 250 grams, and 353 yards. And it's got the different, it's got the normal cotton, which is like a white. And then there's the purple. And then it's got the scrubby stuff, the blue. And then it's got the white. I thought, well, I grabbed a couple of those at my Walmart because our Michaels is closed. We're still, most of the stores are still closed right now. They are slowly opening some of our stores, like car washes, which, I mean, our car washes have been open since this all had happened because we don't have any car washes where people wash your car for you, so they've never closed down. Obviously gas stations are open, Walmart's always been open, the grocery stores, Tim Hortons has stayed open, the liquor store stayed open. They're going to do construction sites, they're going to slowly open them up. What they had said is it's going to be like a three-step to slowly opening things and have they call it a bubble. So the first step, you can have two bubbles, which is one family in one household. And then you could pick another family or friend from another household. So that'd be the two bubbles combined. And then the second step would be like three bubbles, four bubbles. And then the final step, what they plan on doing is getting everybody out into the world, because we've all been cooped up inside the house to get us used to being around people again. It hasn't been too bad here. It's we've got 25 cases, but it's the retirement homes. There's a one up the street from us, like a couple blocks. It's a retirement home for older people, and that's where the 25 cases are. So it's sad knowing that, you know, the elderlies are getting hit by this, but it is what it is, right? Like, I feel sorry for them. And when you're a lot older and have health issues, it's hard not to, because what they're doing is they're stopping people from coming in, but they're not stopping the ones coming out. So they can come out and go shopping or whatever, but nobody can go in and see them. So, yeah. But anyways, this one here is Burnett Handcrafter Cotton, 100% cotton. 12 ounces, 340 grams, 573 yards, medium 4 weight. Knitting needle, 4.5 millimeter, crochet hook, 5 millimeter. And this color is Queen Anne's Lace, and it's an off-white white and two shades brown. It's a really nice color. And these I've got up there. I've got three there, so I had picked up four of those ones. This one here, it's the Burnett Handcrafter, 100% cotton. Same measurements, medium core weight, 573 yards. And this one is Sonoma print, and it's a brown, and it's got little spots in that one there. And that one I think I just have one of those on that one. And then this one here, I picked up two I had made. Yeah, I've only got two of these ones. Well, one and a half, because I made some dishcloths and a dish towel. And this one is salt and pepper. It's just a white and a black. And it's got the stuff in there. And this other cotton, I got four, I think, of these ones. And this one is called Chocolate Om. I like this one here. Self-striping. It's like the dark brown, light brown, white. It's 100% cotton. And two, I don't know what this is. Dishcloth. It requires one ball, 5mm hook. It's got a pattern on there. Made in Canada from 100% U.S. cotton. So that's that. And this here, I love the tweed. It's really, really, really soft. Burnett Premium Tweeds. It's a medium 4 weight. Crochet hook 5mm. Knitting needle 5mm. 90% acrylic. 3% viscose. 7 ounces, 198 grams, and 360 yards. Now, I've got 8 balls of this stuff. I haven't decided what I wanted to make for it. When I bought it, I did have something in mind to make with it, but then I bought it, got it home, and I was like, what was I making with this? But this one is Aran Tweed. This one here. Really, really. And then this one here, I have 4 balls of. I don't know what I'm making with it. It's called Calf a Lot. 100% acrylic, 7 ounces, 198 grams, 360 yards. And it's Premier, Burnett Premier. 5.5mm crochet hook. Machine washable and dryable. It's a brown, but it's a latte brown. And that's the brand of that one. And then I picked up more cotton yarns. These are the 1 pound cotton blend, 454 grams. Made in China, and this is the bread. There's 3 in the bag. And this one, and then I picked up a blue, same thing, it's the 1 pound, 454 grams cotton blend. And that's the blue. I don't know if you guys can see that. And they just come in. I got them at my Giant Tiger store here in town, and they were only $7.97, regular $12.42, but they sold them for $7.97. And then this one here, it's from Cambridge Fibers LTD, hand knitting yarn. Perfect for sweaters, scarves, afghans, mittens, slippers, booties, etc. Super pound, 454 grams minimum weight, 100% unknown fibers, do not dye, no dye lot, machine wash, lay flat to dry. Value pack, and it does have the address. It's 215 Queen Street West, Cambridge, Ontario, Canada. And this is black. I know it's hard to see because it's pretty dark, but there's three balls in this one. There's a small one up top there, and then another one here, and then this big one down at the bottom. So there's that. And this is the same. It's the Cambridge Fibers value pack. Machine wash, lay flat to dry. It's a off-white. It's a cotton. And I got two bags of those. I mean, it's a great deal, like $7.97 for two balls in a bag, or three, four, whatever they come with. I mean, this one is regular $9.99, so. And then this is some of my finished projects. My daughter wanted me to make her and her boyfriend some dish towels. So this one here is made out of the, I think it's the top. I'm way over here. The top one right there. And it's a Burnett Super Value Big Stripes, that one there. So I made, that's the top part. I like how it mixed together, like how it just came perfectly together for that one. And my daughter likes green, so I had to do a green one for her. And I think these are from Bag O' Day or Creative Grandma. I'm not 100% sure. I think Creative Grandma's pattern. And I think I gotta put bigger buttons on because it stretches and it doesn't close all the way. So I gotta put bigger buttons on that. And then I just made her a dishcloth so far. I think this pattern was Bag O' Day's. It was front post, back post. And I think two singles put together or something. I'm not too sure on that. And this is made out of the cotton, Karen Cotton Cakes. So I got that one done. It's been pretty nice out lately for outside here. Really haven't had much of a spring lately. It's been, last week it was snowing and I'm like, what the heck is this? So yeah, and then I got this one here, another black of the Burnett Premium. Machine washable, dryable, 100% acrylic, 7 ounce, 360 yards, and it's black. So soft, really, really soft. I think that is everything. I did finish the two baby blankets I was working on. I had three orders, which I sent out already. It was 8 dishcloths and another dish towel. That was one order. And the second order was a dish towel and 5 dishcloths. And then there was baby's dress and hat and booties, and I think a baby blanket. So, yeah, I didn't don't really have too much other than this. Hopefully this COVID, I know they were saying the second wind or whatever is going to come through, but yeah, it's been quite a long 2 months. I'm still laid off of work. I can't wait to get back. I'm going nutty at home. I've been doing a lot of crocheting. I actually pulled out my adult coloring book, so I've been kind of doing that, taking a break from crocheting, kind of going back and forth. So yeah. And thank you all for coming. Please hit that subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you can get notified every time I post a video. And yeah, you guys have a great day, and thank you very much. God bless.